One of the students in one of my classes at Art and Soul had these super crayons. They're gel crayons. They're appropriate for ages 3 and up, which you can see right there. So I thought I'd try them. I mean, why not? What I have here is a sketchbook where I've prepped the pages with gesso. Okay, so I'm going to take similar colors, this green and this kind of light blue. And just draw some lines. They are so creamy and yummy. And then the cool thing is you can smoosh them really easily. So you can blend colors. Someone's going to ask, would you use these in real art as opposed to the sketchbook? I don't know. Oh, I can kind of carve through that. Let me use the color I used on the facing page here. Okay. So I'm going to smoosh these lines. Just taking out another blue. There's a lot of blues in this set. This one is really indigo. I'm going to take a brush and a little bit of water that I'm just going to spray a little water on the spray it on the palette, but what happens if I just spray it directly on the lines? There, that's what I was thinking. You get the kind of water droplets of the spritzed water. There. And then I'm going to mix my brush in the water and see if I can spread the color around a little bit. So these are like water-soluble crayons, but they're really creamy. And make sure not to use them if you're not over the age of 3. I don't know. And here I'm just going to introduce another kind of line with a pencil. Could wipe that all away, it looks like. Yep, it's washable. Well, that's helpful. Now, the one on the facing page, I'll just turn it around like this so I can let that dry. This one I've spritzed with a workable fixative. And so now I'm going to take some white. Actually, this is gesso. And I'm going to kind of give a little veil over that. And that's enough for now. Except I can't resist taking this a little further. I just dried it a bit with a hairdryer, and then I'm using, let's see, a different sort of turquoisey blue to keep going with it. Yeah. There, so I can get some really nice sort of soft edge atmospheric shapes. And then here I'm taking this mixture of white paint. It's titanium white with a fair amount of matte medium. I think that's it. Yeah, so it's kind of a diluted white paint rather than the gesso. And diluted with matte medium, with acrylic medium, not with water. And I haven't spray this with the fixative, so I'm expecting it'll move around a little bit more. So by means of this white paint, I'm kind of editing the marks I've put here. And because it's diluted, I can put kind of a thin veil of paint, or I could build that up and make some really opaque areas that really obscure what's beneath them.